Hi, students and friends. Mr. Welch here, and I'm excited to begin exploring some fun and interesting topics as we learn together. I'm going to kick things off by asking you to think about the last time that you tried something new, something difficult or challenging. Maybe it was learning a new trick on a skateboard, or trying a new gymnastics routine, or maybe even learning how to play an instrument. It may have made you a little nervous, but think about the sense of accomplishment that you felt inside when you figured it out. Or perhaps things didn't work out. Think about the valuable lessons that you learned anyhow. We humans have an innate nature to explore new challenges. We're naturally curious about the unknown, and we often seek to go beyond barriers that we never knew existed. Have you ever looked up at the night sky, wondering what's beyond the limits of the Earth? It's exciting to think about visiting someplace like Mars, a place no other human being has been to before. You may have heard scientists, or even your friends, say things like, "Let's colonize Mars." There might be life on Mars, or there's even evidence that water exists on Mars. Those are really exciting questions. But would you want to be the one that goes to Mars to try and figure out those answers? Mars is the closest planetary neighbor to Earth, but it's still 62 million miles away. Would you be worried about the risks of such a trip? Or what if you knew it was just a one-way trip and you could never return back to Earth? Now, these are all tough questions to answer, but because I'm curious, each question makes me think of even more questions. I wonder what kind of spaceship actually exists that would be able to take humans to Mars. And once we get there, how are we going to land? And once we land, how are we going to be able to conduct our daily lives? Those are all tough challenges. But do you know what gives me confidence? I think about the past times when Americans have ventured into the unknown and we figured it out. Perhaps there are lessons that we can learn when we look to the past and we apply those to the future. What was that first American expedition into the unknown? For that, we need to look back to 1803's Louisiana Purchase, when then-President Thomas Jefferson sent two men, Robert Livingston and James Madison, to France in order to purchase the city of New Orleans. Why? The United States wanted access to the Mississippi River. They were offered the entire Louisiana territory for $15 million, and Thomas Jefferson jumped on the deal. The problem? He wasn't even sure what he bought. Jefferson secured congressional funding for the Corps of Discovery, the first official American expedition into the unknown. In 1803, he sent a letter with instructions to Meriwether Lewis. In it, it listed the goals for learning about the indigenous populations that live there, mapping the terrain, and studying plants and animal life, and for sending evidence of their discoveries back to Jefferson. Jefferson really wanted to find a water route that would cut across the entire North American continent. But it was a dangerous mission into uncharted territory, just like a mission to Mars. There was no guarantee that Lewis or Clark or their group of explorers would even survive. It was so dangerous, in fact, that the instructions had even included how to carry on the mission in the event of Lewis's death. After a six-week preparatory stay in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Lewis launched his keelboat into the Allegheny River. He would select and meet up with his co-leader, William Clark, and around 30 other members of the expedition. It was a very dangerous mission, but unlike any potential mission to Mars, these lands were already inhabited by many indigenous people. And the indigenous populations already had their own rich, established culture, and the Corps would soon encounter them. One of those encounters happened in October of 1804, when the Corps reached what is now Bismarck, North Dakota. That was the home of the Mandans and Hidatsa tribes. The Corps hired a French fur trapper named Toussaint Charbonneau, and it was that trapper's wife who played a crucial role in the expedition. That wife, Sacagawea, was a member of the Shoshone tribe and had been sold to the trapper years earlier. And she was able to introduce Lewis and Clark and the entire Corps to her people just outside the Continental Divide. 30 people were part of Lewis and Clark's expedition, but right now, we're going to learn about one of them. His name? York, a man enslaved by William Clark. York faced the same challenges, exhibited the same courage, and contributed to the same discoveries as the rest of the Corps. York made history on November 24th, when a vote was taken to decide where to set up camp for the winter. York's vote in that decision counted equally, and that happened almost 65 years before the ratification of the 15th Amendment. However, York's other notable contributions were not recognized and not treated with equality. When the group returned to St. Louis after their two-year mission, Lewis wrote a letter to Congress asking them to reward the members of the expedition with land and money. The only name not mentioned in Lewis's letter? York. The enslaved York also asked William Clark for his freedom as compensation for his contributions to the mission, but it was a request that Clark refused. We can celebrate York's courage and contributions now and fill in the gaps from outdated historical texts. And that's another way that we can see progress, asking courageous questions and wanting to know more about our country's past. The Corps of Discovery paved the way for future westward expansion. It was a path that led to significant conflict, and it was a path that led to important discoveries. So as we look to explore Mars, tremendous opportunity awaits. But as we saw with the Corps of Discovery, tremendous risks may lie ahead. These are the questions that I want you to think about. How can diverse groups of people collaborate to make discoveries and build new knowledge? What can we do to encourage and support those diverse groups and ensure that they are recognized? And moreover, if we are able to colonize Mars, what safeguards can we put in place to protect our liberty and our equality as we head into the unknown? These are big questions, but you're big thinkers, and I have full confidence in your ability to meet these challenges and literally reach for the stars.
To download the free lesson plans to be used with this program, visit us online at wqed.org/SOS. To request a hard copy of the lesson plans, please contact your local school district. Funding for this program is provided by the Pennsylvania Department of Education for Learning at Home.